What was your back quote oh crap moment when you realized you shouldn't had broke up with your ex significant other? Not me, but someone whom I casually knew from college. Left his wife because he felt the SEs was awful and he wanted someone whom they felt he could have great SEs with. Wife pleaded with him to stay, no kids, but he refused and filed for divorce. Divorce is finalized about a year later. This guy dates lots of women, but still finds the SEs unsatisfactory. Meanwhile, ex-wife meets this other guy about a year after the divorce and they have that type of whirlwind romance that truly is from a rom-com. She marries this new guy, they have kids, and the perfect marriage. She tells everyone that the divorce was the best thing that ever happened to her and can't believe how happy she is and could never imagine that a marriage could be so wonderful. The guy, who is my friend, is more miserable now than ever. Constantly says what a mistake he made leaving his wife. Doesn't even go on dates anymore and has not had SEs in years. I left her for someone else because I'm an idiot. The other girl turned out to be a jealous, mentally and physically abusive psychopath who eventually ended up in a psychiatric hospital. My significant other, quite rightly, refused to take me back. Lesson learned. My friend dumped his girlfriend of 12 years because he'd never dated anyone but her. They were struggling financially and he wanted the chance to experience more relationships. Right after the breakup, she finished her PhD and started making six figures. She found someone else then got married within a year. My friend tried dating a couple of people, but none of them have worked out, and he still misses her. He said the moment he realized that he made a huge mistake was when he saw her wedding photos on Facebook and started crying. When he called me up the day after I broke up with him to ask me if I was okay. Yeah. Mistake I've regretted for 13 years now. My oh crap moment was when he died in a car accident. We were married for almost 6 years. I was so young, had no idea what I was doing. I wanted a divorce and I can't even remember why. Our son was 7. I have our now 18-year-old. He was the kind of man that was good at everything and a very hard worker. A man's man and a family man. Before he died, we were talking about getting back together. He was my best friend. We were on a break cause I was being a D. In order to get a reaction, I ended the relationship on Facebook. That was the end of the friendship and all. Regretted it ever since. It's only added years of misery to my life. Learn from your mistakes. Delete Facebook. When I was 16, I briefly dated a girl who was 17. She wasn't in my peer group. She was an outsider. But she was nice, had curly blonde hair. I liked her. She had an old 1970 Cadillac, and she let me drive it. I had never driven before, so maneuvering that giant boat on the narrow streets of town was fun. After a few months, my friends were bugging me about why I was wasting my time with this girl. She didn't smoke or drink or listen to hard rock. So I let us drift apart. She turned 18, graduated high school, and then won the New Jersey State Lottery for $6 million. I should have stayed with her. My friends were all bums. My mom left my stepdad, and he got remarried to a great lady and is super happy now. My mom told me recently that leaving him was the biggest mistake she made because he was the only good man she ever really knew. We all have Christmas at their house. Seriously, he and my mom divorced, and he's still grandpa to my sister's kids and we call his new wife our stepmom. They're awesome, but my poor mom has to watch them being happy together every year while she lives alone. I checked out his new GF's social media accounts and saw how they were living exactly the same kind of life we had and also living out things that my ex and I had planned. The difference is she seems so happy about it. Her captions about him shows how she treasures him and thinks highly of him, like she's so lucky to have him. He is indeed a good man. But during our time together, he hadn't really figured out stuff yet. I felt like I always had to encourage him, to motivate him. I felt that I was always going to be the captain and cheerleader in the relationship. When I read his current GF's captions, it wasn't a no crap moment exactly, more of a disconcerting feeling of was I wrong? Should I have been happier with that role? With what we had? Should I have not wished for more? Is there even a more? But ultimately, I'm happy for him. I don't think I'd ever be loved like that again though. Edit after reading the comments. I do take social media with a grain of salt. Her captions about him are not exaggerations though. I know because I would have used the same words to describe him. What was unsettling for me was the thought that I didn't really focus on those positive qualities. I always question things. Were we moving at the same pace? Are we doing the right things to reach our goals? Why aren't we progressing as fast as X and Y? New GF is a bit older, more settled in life, and seems a lot more accepting and easygoing. Well, he's also doing so much better now. The weird feeling comes from the fact that I could have just as easily assumed the same point of view she has, and our lives would have been totally different. My fiancé had the issue of not being super motivated, and was stuck in a rut of being a mid-20s college dropout with no real direction or goals. It was a source of anxiety for him, not that he just didn't care, and I think his ex-girlfriend would push him in ways that didn't quite work for him, and that he wasn't ready for. She ultimately broke up with him in part because of this. I'm pretty sure she had already built up another relationship, since she was engaged 6 months later. I think he took the lessons from this previous relationship and put on a brave face when we got together. I was very patient and supportive and encouraging in the same way you probably had to be, but he was finally ready to do the work. He went back to school, got a new job in a new industry, quit smoking, started doing a martial art, reads all the time, and became physically active otherwise. I'm sure his ex looks at him and thinks, "What the hell, all the time now, haha." The point of this ramble being that you breaking up with him may have been the slap of reality he needed to start being more self-motivating and making different choices in life, not that you were doing anything wrong while you were together. My first relationship ever with a girl who I'd end up losing my virginity to, and experiencing so many other first time things with. We were seniors in high school when we started dating, so college was around the corner. I didn't really get much attention from girls in high school, but when I went to college I started growing up and started getting attention. I was still dating this girl and we were madly in love. But I was almost obsessed with this new attention I was getting. Girls I'd never really talked to in high school were now reaching out to me trying to hang out. Girls who I'd never even attempt to talk to were now flirting with me at college. I broke up with my high school sweetheart the summer after freshman year of college, because I thought I could do better in the looks department. It ended up being my biggest regret, because she is by far the best girl I've ever known. I was just too young, inexperienced, and stupid to realize it. Now she's living with a guy she met shortly after me. They've been together for 6 or 7 years, and are on their way to getting married. Her and I still keep in touch whenever something reminds us of each other. Not in a romantic way, but just as a sort of nostalgic kind of thing. Miss the hell out of her, but I'm happy she's happy. I have a fantasy that in 10 to 15 years we run into each other at a hotel bar or an airport terminal, and we are both single and rekindle what we used to have. Edit. Sometimes fallouts or experiences like this end up being extremely valuable. I learned so much from my first relationship and it's only made me a better partner in the long run. I'm much more self-aware and appreciative of what I have while I have it. One of my exes I just never made time for. She was a great girl, we got along well, I just had different priorities at that point in my life. She brought it up to me twice, she put in effort to fix it, tried scheduling dates, sat down and talked to me, and explained why she was feeling hurt. And I'd change for a week. But I'd go back to my old ways. I just wasn't committed. I had other focuses, namely my career. Finally she just said she still enjoyed my company, but couldn't call seeing me once a week for a 2 to 3 hours a relationship. Even after she tried to stay friends, but time between my responses got longer and longer until eventually I looked at it, and her last text was from over a month ago. I felt too ashamed to respond, I probably should have. But I don't blame her. She had needs I was not paying attention to, so I guess it's more she broke up with me, but she didn't want to. I forced her hand by just not being around. The important thing was I learned from it. I learned I needed to pay more attention to my partners. I learned that, just because I'm very long-term focused, that I cannot ignore the more immediate concerns and justify it with it'll pay off in the long run. And that is a lesson that has led to success since then. I broke up with a woman I was head over heels in love with over something that on reflection was fairly minor. Spent half a year progressively dropping into a deeper and deeper funk. Wouldn't admit it to myself at all that I'd made the wrong choice. I was hanging out with a friend when she pointed out to me that she had never seen me as happy as I'd been when I was with my so. Another friend pointed out that same week that the music I'd binging had become much more depressing over the past few months and asked me if something was wrong. That woke me up and made me realize how special she had been. It took another year for me to realize she was the first woman I'd really loved in the way you come to love somebody for who they are, rather than what you imagine them to be. I never saw her again. I wish I'd never left her. We only would have had 6 years together, as she came down with cancer that eventually killed her. It didn't change how I felt. I'd take those 6 years in exchange for all the years I have left. Because I was a very stupid young man who wasn't thinking at all. I had dated her for a little bit before I broke up with her, cause another girl who I thought was hotter showed a lot of interest in me, and it got really messy after that before we simply stopped existing to one another. That girl I left had been my longest steadfast friend who cared about me way more deeply than I ever deserved. Every relationship since then has exposed very deep flaws in me as a person and allowed me to make very ducking stupid mistakes that I wish had never happened. Every so often I think what if, but I'm not dwelling in the past. She now has an amazing man and I wish them the utmost happiness in this life and the next. I have worked tirelessly to reform myself, so I never hurt anyone or make the mistakes I did, and also so that if I meet a girl like that again, I don't mess up again. I pushed her away because I got overwhelmed. I don't know if it's a no crap moment, but I miss her. I have this habit in relationships where I always end things whenever I feel overwhelmed. I really really loved her, but little things start to pile up. I don't say how I feel because I just don't like confrontation. And then one day I just didn't love her like I used to. I don't know why. And with her, I fell back in love with her for a while and I opened up to her about it. She tried to get me to open up to her more regularly about how I'm feeling, but I just can't. I fell out again and ended it. She tried so hard to figure things out with us, but it just, I didn't want to try. It didn't seem fair to her to continue this, when I'm just going to keep feeling suffocated. And when she tried to help, I felt trapped. I don't know why I'm like this. And I know she really cared and loved me. Part of me wants to reach out to her again and really mend things, and figure out how to not feel so suffocated anymore. I don't think it's anything she did. She was really understanding. It's just me. I don't know how to deal with me. And I miss her. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.